Hello everyone, welcome to Excel Education with an aim to benefit you from daily current affairs MCQ. We have been creating such videos. We hope the videos are really helpful to you, and with this hope, let us begin our today's video. Starting with the first question, who among the following has published the Global Employment Trends for Youth 2020 report? Option A, International Labour Organization. Option B, World Bank Group. Option C, United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization. Option D, World Economic Forum. The correct answer for this is option A, International Labour Organization. The Global Employment Trends for Youth 2020, Technology and the Future of Jobs has been released by the International Labour Organization. The number of young people currently not in employment, education or training is rising, and young women are more than twice as likely as their male counterparts to be affected. Globally, one-fifth of young people currently have NEET status, which means they are neither gaining experience in the labor market nor receiving an income from work nor enhancing their education and skills. Young people who are employed also face a greater risk than older workers of losing their jobs because of automation. Moving on to the next question, Inclusive Wealth Report, sometimes seen in news, is released by option A, German Watch. Option B, Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change. Option C, UN Environment. Option D, World Bank. The correct answer for this is option C, UN Environment. The Inclusive Wealth Report is a biennial effort led by the UN Environment to evaluate the capacities and performance of the nations around the world to measure sustainability of economy and well-being of their people. Inclusive Wealth Index, as part of the Inclusive Wealth Report, is a tool assessing a nation's ability to look after its wealth in a way that is sustainable and safeguards its future generations. While GDP measures the size of a country's economy, Inclusive Wealth Index focuses on stocks of manufactured, human and natural capital. Moving on to the next question, which among the following constitutes the provisions under right to freedom of religion? Statement 1, right of minorities to establish and administer cultural and educational institutions. Statement 2, freedom to manage religious affairs. Statement 3, freedom from payment of taxes for promotion of any religion. Statement 4, protection of language, script and culture of religious minorities. Choose correct answer. Option A, 2 and 3. Option B, 2 and 4. Option C, 1, 2 and 3. Option D, 2, 3 and 4. The correct answer for this is option A, 2 and 3. The below are the provisions that comes under the category of right to freedom of religion. Freedom of conscience and free profession, practice and propagation of religion, which is article number 25. Freedom to manage religious affairs, article number 26. Freedom from payment of taxes for promotion of any religion, article number 27. Freedom from attending religious instruction or worship in certain educational institutions, article 28. Now, cultural and educational rights, which is from article 29 to article 30, consist of protection of language, script and culture of minorities, which is article 29, right of minorities to establish and administer educational institution, article 30. Heading to the next question, we have, consider the following statements regarding the Personal Data Protection Bill 2019. Statement 1, it is based on the recommendations of the Justice B.N. Srikrishna Committee. Statement 2, It governs the companies incorporated in India as well as foreign companies dealing with personal data of individuals in India. Which of the statements given above are correct? Option A, one only. Option B, two only. Option C, both one and two. Option D, neither one nor two. The correct answer for this is option C, both one and two. The Statement of Objects and Reasons of the Personal Data Protection Bill 2019 states that the bill is based on the recommendations of Committee of Experts on Data Protection, chaired by Justice B.N. Srikrishna, to examine the issues relating to data protection and the suggestions received from various stakeholders. It lays down obligations on entities collecting personal data to collect only that data which is required for a specific purpose and with the express consent of the individual. It governs the processing of personal data by government, companies incorporated in India, and foreign companies dealing with personal data of individuals in India. Personal data is data which pertains to characteristics, traits, or attributes of identity which can be used to identify an individual. It aims to establish an authority to be called the Data Protection Authority of India to protect the interest of data principles, prevent any misuse of personal data, ensure compliance with the provisions. The Personal Data Protection Bill 2019 was introduced in Lok Sabha in December 2019 and was referred to Standing Committee. Moving on to the next question. Consider the following statements about Bharatmala Pariyojana. Statement 1. It is centrally sponsored and funded road and highways project of the Government of India. Statement 2. It is component of Sagarmala project umbrella program to enhance the performance of the country's logistics sector. Select the correct statements. Option A, 1 only. Option B, 2 only. Option C, both 1 and 2. Option D, neither 1 nor 2. The correct answer for this is option A, 1 only. It is a centrally sponsored and funded road and highways project of the Government of India. Now let us learn something about Bharatmala Pariyojana. It is a new umbrella program for the highway sector that focuses on optimizing efficiency of freight and passenger movement across the country. It bridges critical infrastructure gaps through effective interventions like developments of economic corridors, inter-corridors, and feeder routes, national corridor efficiency improvement, border and international connectivity roads, coastal and port connectivity roads, and greenfield expressways. It is a centrally sponsored and funded road and highways project of the Government of India. It is both enabler and beneficiary of other key Government of India schemes such as Sagarmala, dedicated freight corridors, industrial corridors, Uran, RCS, BharatNet, Digital India, and Make in India. Heading to the next question. Consider the following statements regarding the wholesale price index. Statement 1. It is released by the Office of the Economic Advisor Department of Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade. Statement 2. Fuel and power inflation is not included in the wholesale price index calculation. Which of the statements given above are correct? Option A, 1 only. Option B, 2 only. Option C, both 1 and 2. Option D, neither 1 nor 2. The correct answer for this is option A, 1 only. It is released by the Office of the Economic Advisor Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade. The Office of the Economic Advisor Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade, Ministry of Commerce and Industry, releases the monthly wholesale price index for India. The index basket of the wholesale price index covers commodities falling under the three major groups, namely primary articles, fuel and power, and manufactured products. Primary articles have a weightage of 22.6%, fuel and power have a weightage of 13.2%, and manufactured products have a weightage of 64.2%. Heading to the next question. Recently, Union Ministry of Law and Justice declared United Arab Emirates as a reciprocating territory. Consider the following statements regarding reciprocating territory. Statement 1. Reciprocating territory means any country or territory outside India where orders passed by certain designated courts in that territory can be implemented in India. Statement 2. A country is declared as a reciprocating territory under the provisions of Civil Procedure Code 1908. Which of the above statements are correct? Option A. 1 only. Option B. 2 only. Option C. Both 1 and 2. Option D. Neither 1 nor 2. The correct answer for this is Option C. Both 1 and 2. Both the options are correct. The Ministry of Law and Justice issued an extraordinary gazette notification declaring the United Arab Emirates to be a reciprocating territory under Section 44A of the Civil Procedure Code 1908. Essentially, orders passed by certain designated courts from a reciprocating territory can be implemented in India by filing a copy of the decree concerned in a district court here. The courts so designated are called superior courts. Moving on to the next question. Consider the following statements regarding Comet Neowise. Statement 1. It was discovered by Hubble Space Telescope of NASA. Statement 2. It is a periodic comet and appears in Earth's vicinity about every 75 years. Which of the statements given above are correct? Option A. 1 only. Option B. 2 only. Option C. Both 1 and 2. Option D. Neither 1 nor 2. The correct answer for this is Option D. Neither 1 nor 2. Both the statements are incorrect. C2020F3 is a retrograde comet with a near parabolic orbit discovered by astronomers using the Neowise Space Telescope, hence called Comet Neowise. Neowise Telescope is a NASA Infrared Wavelength Astronomical Space Telescope launched in December 2009 and placed in hibernation mode in February 2011. It was reactivated in 2013 to identify and characterize the population of near-Earth objects. Neowise comet was discovered on March 27, 2020 and is a non-periodic comet. Moving on to the next question. Consider the following statements regarding the Pragyata guidelines for digital education. Statement 1. These have been released by the Ministry of Human Resource and Development. Statement 2. These guidelines are binding in nature for all states or union territories. Which of the statements given above are correct? Option A. 1 only. Option B. 2 only. Option C. Both 1 and 2. Option D. Neither 1 nor 2. The correct answer for this is Option A. 1 only. These have been released by the Ministry of Human Resource and Development. The Human Resource and Development Ministry has announced Pragyata guidelines for digital education for online classes operationalized by schools amid the COVID pandemic. These guidelines are advisory in nature and have been prepared by NCERT. States or union territories are required to come out with their own detailed guidelines by adapting or modifying these guidelines in accordance with their requirements and assessment of the local situation. The guidelines recommend a cap on the screen time for students depending on class. The Pragyata guidelines include 8 steps of digital learning, that is, plan, review, arrange, guide, yuck or talk, assign, track, appreciate. The guidelines also emphasize the need to unify all efforts related to digital online education benefiting school-going children across the country. The initiative includes Diksha, Swayam Prabha, Radio Bahini and Shiksha Vani. Moving on to the next question. The term Sebite was in news often. It is associated with Option A. Name of the royal family of Travancore who oversee the administration of Sri Padmanabhaswamy temple in Kerala. Option B. Pujaris who perform worship in Hindu temples. Option C. Solo performance depicting themes of love and relationships mentioned in the संस्कृत टेक्स्ट नट्य शास्त्र. ऑप्शन डी, एनी पर्सन हु हैज राइट्स टू मैनेज प्रॉपर्टीज लाइक द टेम्पल और एनी अदर लैंड और प्रॉपर्टी विच इज वेस्टेड विद द डीटी. द करेक्ट आंसर फॉर दिस इज ऑप्शन डी, एनी पर्सन हु हैज राइट्स टू मैनेज प्रॉपर्टीज लाइक द टेम्पल और एनी अदर लैंड और प्रॉपर्टी विच इज वेस्टेड विद द डीटी. अबाउट सीवेट, अ सीवेट इज एनी पर्सन हु सर्व्स एंड सपोर्ट्स द डीटी एंड वर्क्स एज अ मैनेजर ऑफ द डेब्यूटर प्रॉपर्टी. द प्रॉपर्टीज लाइक द टेम्पल और एनी अदर लैंड और प्रॉपर्टी विच इज वेस्टेड विद द डीटी आर मैनेज्ड बाय द सीवेट. सीवेट इज द ओनली पर्सन हु हैज द पावर टू टॉक ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ द डीटी दैट इज द गॉड और गॉडेस. He has the power to deal with all the affairs of the deity. So this is the end of today's video. We hope you liked the video. So please like and share our video and subscribe to our channel for the upcoming videos. Thank you.